Next guest has been one of the best dressed rock stars in Aussie music for decades. And here's a reminder of the many hit songs he had us singing along to.
Too many times I've seen the sun come up, you bloodshot eyes this week.
Smith from Mentalist.
Yay! Yay!
We are so excited to have
so
you here
good
this
to
morning,
have
Green.
You can have your Martin Plazas, you can have your Reg Mombassas. You were always my favourite. I love you.
Now, tell us what's behind your nickname, Greedy.
Unfortunately, I went to a college function. This is really in the 70s,
yes.
early days of Mentalist anything, setting up our gear in an empty hall at the teacher's college. And these people bring in these big long white boxes like this, and I thought, that looks like I could set up a Farfisa organ in front of me. I've got another table and put the big box there, and I can be like somebody in an old prog rock band, like Yes, like Rick Wakeman. We have a big keyboard ring.
Yeah, I love it.
All the punters come in, they open these boxes, the other boxes, and they're full of KFC, and they start. And I thought, this is all right. So I did this show. I played with my right hand, and I ate chicken with my left. I had about 16. I had about 16 pieces, and Reg Mombassas started calling me Greedy, and you know.
It's stuck for all these
one goat. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. And that's been forever.
Talking about the good old days, we were just looking at the clip for the Nibs of Getting Beer. Yeah. You made that for $300.
$300. Yeah. We used out-of-date film stock in the Festival Records loading dock. Not far from here, actually.
Oh, yeah, so God.
That goes back, I think that's originally released about 40 years.
Wow.
Next year, I think.
Wow.
Is it
just up the street where IGA is? I thought it was.
I love IGA, but it's not. You can't record in there anymore.
It's still got records and signs and things up.
Yeah, it's which is nice.
History.
It's a bit like we stay at the Festival Towers in Brisbane. Have you been the one up there, which is where Festival Hall in Brisbane is?
Yeah.
And it's full of the best photos. It's got every pictures of every band.
Mm. Do you miss those old days? I mean, it feels like...
No, I don't miss them because I'm still there.
Yeah.
Because I'm still doing the same thing. I still turn up to work. You know, harmonicas are there, keyboards are there, punters are there.
Because the songs are just so fabulous. And sort of upbeat. They make me smile when I listen to them.
I think that's like... Well, that was because we were an art school band. Originally, we had to play to art students.
Mm-hmm.
So we had to not be pompous because they could smell pomposity a mile away. You can't be smart. You had to be, you know, a bit on their side.
Yes.
So we'd do a few Monkees covers and we'd do that. And then the songs that we write ourselves would have to be... They had to be friendly songs.
Yes.
Mm. And, of course, there was The World Seems Difficult, which was another big hit for them. There was a sad song. Now, speaking of rock and roll history, your band actually started in the 1970s on the night Elvis died.
Is that
Is
that right?
The day after the night Elvis... When we found out about Elvis dying during the day. Now, it's interesting because on that day, we've worked out since then... I mean, Martin Plaza just painted a big... picture of Elvis. We'd already doing Elvis songs in a set. We did a few
is
more.
Is that what made you decide?
No, that was the day that our longest lineup actually started. That's when Peter O'Doherty joined the band. So that's it. At the same night, in other places in Sydney, In Excess did their first show under the name of In Excess. They changed it to Ferris Brothers to In Excess.
They never amounted to
it. And on the same night in Sydney, somewhere else again, Midnight Oil did their first show. Under the name of Midnight Oil. They were farmed before that, and it intended to be. So there was a lot. So
history.
Elvis has a lot to answer.
Elvis should have died more often.
Now you always seem to be wearing a suit in the clips.
Yeah.
Was it a thing?
I think it's management pressure. modesty. I think a lot of modesty.
That was part of the look. But look at you now. You've got beads, Hawaiian shirts.
It's midlife crisis. Well, it's past that. Well past the midlife crisis.
Metal, if anything, is still touring, and you've got two concerts coming up.
My word, we've got a double Panthers extravaganza.
Oh, I love a double
Panthers. We've got Panthers on Port Macquarie. Panthers Port Macquarie. But it's not just us. This is the lineup. It's Darryl Braithwaite, recently inducted again into the ARIA Hall of Fame. He must be third time King of Pop. he's there with his band, who are incredible. Russell Morris, he does it, real thing, all that. Do you know his blues trilogy, the first album of that, Shark Mouth, has been in the charts, the album charts in Australia, top 100. Or top 40 since it was released three years. It's like Dark Side of the Moon.
But it's brilliant, isn't it?
And the Bad Loves. And the Bad Loves. And Metal Is Anything. Yeah, thank
you. Wow.
So those four acts.
You're the best, though.
Yeah, of course. We have, we've got Panthers Port Macquarie Friday.
Yep.
Panthers in Penrith. The original Panthers.
It's great. It's my
favourite. And then we're off to play Brisbane. Penrith on Saturday night. And on the Sunday, we are playing at the Redland Bay with us and the fabulous Radiators who've been around nearly as long as we have.
Who gets to play first? How do you work out
the order?
You play last because you're the...
Is it rock, paper, scissors?
No. Scissors, paper, rock? I haven't
looked at my worksheet. I did just back there. I just worked out
headline
Friday, Port Macquarie, Saturday, Penrith, Sunday...
Brisbane.
Greedy, do you still get a real buzz when you get on stage?
I do. You know, the main reason I really love it is that when you write songs yourself, because we started as a cover band, when you write songs yourself and they recognise your songs amongst the covers you do, that's a huge buzz. And you never get, and when they clap it, when you play the first chord, and they go, ah! You never get over that.
No.
You wouldn't need to be paid.
It's a drug.
Oh, no. And one night stand, as we just heard before, is at Panthers Port Macquarie on Friday night, then Panthers Penrith on Saturday night. Please thank the wonderful Greedy Sweet.